Firefighters risk their lives every day to keep us safe. Their work puts them in dangerous and unhealthy situations. Now, Hawaii firefighters are asking for help. Brent Romagna joins us with more. Brent?
Joe, firefighters here in Hawaii can get workers' compensation benefits if they are injured on the job, and that covers certain injuries. But there's one thing that isn't on the list, and that's what they're hoping to change.
Certain type of cancers occur 1.5 times to 2 times more often for firefighters.
It's a shocking statistic, especially since the people involved are the men and women who are putting their lives in harm's way to save others. Assistant Fire Chief Socrates Britakos of the Honolulu Fire Department says he's part of the statistic.
I was diagnosed with a kind of a leukemia, non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, back about end of 2010. I was treated in early 2011, and I have been in remission since the summer.
Britako says he's fortunate the cancer was treatable, but due to strict laws, he and others are unable to receive workers' compensation if they develop cancer. Now he's making a plea to lawmakers to help other firefighters.
We want the intent of the law to get looked at, to be able to provide help for firefighters who get sick as a result of the job, and get them help and financial help a little faster.
If a firefighter is hurt on the job, there is workers' compensation. The hard part is proving their job caused cancer. A study done by the University of Cincinnati shows the risk of firefighters getting cancer compared to the general population. A firefighter has a 102% higher chance of getting testicular cancer, a 51% higher chance of developing non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, and a 39% higher chance of getting skin cancer.
We still come in contact with carcinogens. It's just a matter of fact, if you're in fires or exposed to hazardous materials, you do have more contact with them, and your chances of contracting cancer go up.
While Britakos is thankful he was able to overcome his cancer, he says there are others who are fighting the fight today and future firefighters who will also have to deal with this life-changing disease. And that's why he wants something done so the men and women who always help others can get a little help themselves.
I know that it's tough. I was a treatable case, but I see other people going through even tougher time than I went through.
Ritako said there are 33 states that currently have these laws that allow firefighters to receive workers' compensation benefits. And as always, we'll be following up to see if the bill is passed. Brent Romodnik, KHON 2 News.